time reduction.
And I'm HR with my assistant director of disruption.
Before we get started with the show, we have a few important announcements for you.
First off, no video recording or flash photography during the performance, except for MCA, of course. We will have this recording and it will be shared.
Speaking of the show, it's about 95 minutes long with a 15-minute intermission after Act 1.
During that intermission, you can take the exit and go to your right, where we'll be selling concessions. But please remember, no food or drinks are allowed back in the theater except the bottled water.
Also, during intermission, if you use the restroom, exit out to your right and to the left are the bathrooms. If that is confusing for you, you know where those are at. There are plenty of students and teachers around to direct you to those bathrooms. Also, speaking of exits, if there's an emergency for any reason and we need to exit the building immediately, exit to my left, my right, your left, your right. And a few things about this show itself. Did you know about the dozen? It's not a fictional tale. It's indeed based on the historical Gilbreth family that lived in New Jersey in the 1920s and 30s. It got its name from a little phrase that Mr. Gilbreth, Frank Sr., often said when he was out in public with his 12 dozen kids. He would often get asked, "Oh my gosh, all those are kids? Why do you have so many?" And he would often reply, "Oh, well, they come cheaper by the dozen." And originally was a book written by his oldest siblings, Ernestine and Frank, and this book has been turned into a play in your live viewing classroom. So without further ado, New Tomorrow Now presents
Cheaper by the Dozen.
Take out his stopwatch and whistle assembly call. trimmings. Keep inviting them. Dirty. These trimmings. Hiding. Biting. No. No. Hold on, Jack. Look at those nails. What do you think of them? What you need is a manicure set to keep your nails clean. I've got more manicure sets for the girls and jack knives for the boys. Here you are.
Feet and
victory.
Yes, dear.
Okay.
is it?
To begin with, these underthings, these teddies. I'm going to wear them.
You will not! Look at these! You'll put them back in the box! It embarrasses me to even look at them!
I bought them without money!
You're going to take them back to the store!
There's only one other girl in school who wears a teddy.
If you don't believe us, come to school and see for yourself.
That won't be necessary.
That's all they talk about.
You should see him in the halls, in the lunchroom.
Yes, Dad. Shame you, boys. Come on.
I guess you might as well know. It isn't just teddies. I bought silk stockings.
No!
And then
you can see right through them. They're like the last of the seven males.
Now you know.
Do boys think when they see a girl wearing silk stockings?
What, Dad?
Never mind.
But everyone wears them. Boys don't notice when everyone dresses that way.
Don't tell me about what boys notice. I know all about what boys notice.
You don't want to be wallflowers.
I'd rather raise wallflowers than clinging vines.
I'm going to wear them. I'll not be a wallflower anymore.
And I'm going to wear silk stockings too.
I won't let you in the house with them!
Don't you see, Dad? I've never even been asked to the drugstore for a plain ordinary vanilla soda!
What is vanilla soda you want?
Dad!
And boys don't get serious about the type of girl who wears silk stockings.
If you ask me, it's a dead giveaway to be so suspicious. It jokes in this head you.
Nobody asked you. And when a man picks a wife, he wants someone that he can respect.
They certainly respect me. I'm the most respected girl in the whole school. The boys respect me so much they hardly look at me.
And come back here. I don't want you wasting time with a lot of boys. Get on the phone right here with a family project.
You don't understand! You just don't understand at all! I wish your job was selling shoes! And you only had one or two children! And you!
Where, I remember.
All the same, you should be doing even better in your studies. Skipping grades isn't going to be a topic of general interest for our family discussion then. Silk stockings? Who's next? You want to paint yourself?
They don't call it painting anymore.
I don't care what they call it. I don't have any painted women in this household.
What you want is a household of old maids.
What I want is for you to get ahead with things. Things that matter. By yourselves. You're not be having to hound you all the time.
And the topic of tonight's family council is to be great in school.
Yes, why jingle a little more organization around here?
We voted all topics to be of general interest.
Better organization is always of general interest.
That's so smart. Why can't you understand?
Oh, you poor thing.
You're moving. No!
there any topics of general interest?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to go into the topic of families that were overstayed.
That's not general interest.
I'm interested. That's moving.
Sit down.
But the trouble is, you always decide what's of general interest, and we never get a chance to. I don't think that's very democratic.
Nonsense. I always favor the discussion with the family councils of general interest before going to the subject matter.
I might sometimes see a boy who's in my history class.
Not of general interest.
Oh, he is. We're all very interested.
Not me. I'm bored stiff. Now, if you might sometimes see a two-headed boy, that would be of general interest.
I'd be very interested in a two-headed boy.
Now, I have a very first-rate topic. I'm going to teach you all a new method of multiplication that is bound to make a wonderful impression on your math teacher. Remember, a lot of little things like this end up skipping grades in school.
Is that general interest, Daddy?
That, son, is of utmost general interest. Now, before I get into multiplication, I have an announcement to make. I've been invited to speak at the World Management Conference in London. And despite the opposition of a few worries, I intend to go. Now, I want to leave things running smoothly for your mother.
They're not set to load.
I want to organize purchasing committees to buy food, utilities, and clothes. Then, utilities officers, so there'll be 5-cent fines to the wasters of food and water.
Well, all of course, Dad. And since that's settled, I think we ought to adjourn.
It's getting late.
It sure is.
7:30. I want us to all be doing better. And our studies as well, skipping grades now and then.
But we're all doing fine in our studies, Dad. And since that's settled, I think we ought to adjourn.
I second the motion.
I think that we have the most efficient family in the entire world.
I think we're all in favor. And I think we ought to adjourn.
You could be doing better in your schoolwork. Anything that detracts you from that.
Sure thing.
Not now.
I'll show you one cheer. Then we'll get going.
okay? Okay.
No, no, don't!
What are you worried about? Come on, follow me. Let's have a hoop, rah, bray! And a tiger form a flare high! A hoop, rah, bray! And a tiger! I want to hear you call it now, ready?
Ready.
Hoop! Rah!
Chicken.
Here's your approach. Four wheels, no brakes. 15 you love to touch.
Those old jalopies were just as good as our own car.
Remember riding with Dad in the old Pier Zero? Someone called out, "I see 12 kids!" And Dad bellowed back, "These aren't much. You ought to see the ones I left at home." And one time someone shouted, "What are you doing in that old art?" And Dad shouted back, "I'm collecting animals like the good Lord told me to. Now all I need now is a jackass. Hop it!"
The most embarrassing part was when we come to a toll bridge and Dad played his favorite game. He guessed the nationality of the country then. "Hey, do my motor train come here to ride the bus?"
What is it? Wasn't meant for a fun like that to be told.
Sometimes it was a Dutch collector.
Ah! But the fun most of the Dutchman, yeah, right from the house.
Even out for a drive, he couldn't stop teaching. I mean, if we passed the factory, he'd explain how they used a slum line to get the chimney stripped.
Because he was in a hurry, for all of us. I guess all those systems, study projects, committees, were you terrible instead of purchasing committee?
The purchasing committee got wholesale rates from underwear to baseballs. And just look at the saving on canned food when we ordered direct by the top.
But what about the 96 stars of peanut butter?
Everyone likes lots of peanut butter.
Not me, not anymore.
The committees were a wonderful thing. They eliminated waste motions and made things easier for mother.
You didn't talk that way back then. Back then, my people talked about was boys and ladies and dates.
Because the boy hardly dared call at our house. That little cheerleader did everything but nail a quarantine sign on our door.
And I remember Anne burning up. "I'm going to make sure you can only be described as hell on earth."
And Dad picked that particular time to set up the efficiency program.
Well, he didn't exactly pick that time.
I didn't mean...
Sure. None of us knew. It just seemed like a lot of the times he was extra impatient.
Like the time the lady psychologist came to give us those examinations.
But we didn't know about those things. How they might mean Anne could graduate ahead of her class.
Dad's master plan. He was so anxious for Anne to get through school right then, so she could be free to help mother.
But didn't she go to a movie with some boy that afternoon?
She didn't know the exam meant anything. She didn't know Dad had been talking to the people at school about graduating her early.
But she missed all of dinner. And most of the tests, that was wild.
Checking his watch every 3 minutes, if the psychology teacher hadn't been there, he'd have been roaring like a lion.
And you and I finished the exams early. I guess some of the others went upstairs.
Do you hear that? That isn't coming from down the street. That's an apartment building. That's upstairs.
All of them.
We better speak to Mom.
Before Dad comes here.
Quiet! Shut off that noise! Sit quiet! You too! Who's playing those?
I don't know.
Did Anne come in?
No use trying to get around me now. Come down here! I said come down here! How did you do on your trick examination?
Practically perfect.
Me too.
No trouble with Miss Morello? Looks like you finished pretty early. You and whoever turned off those breakers.
Good job.
Oh, so okay.
You spent as much time studying as you did memorizing those stupid songs? You could recite the Quran forward and backwards.
He could abortion that reaches good, that was master as cult. He could sign off a puppet.
Where is Shokka, Thornebu, Thornebu?
He cries me for Celeste, they don't get lost in the approaching him.
Sonne Martine.
I mark the house, I can tell you.
Ding dong bell.
No, let's have a little more jazz. Let's have that song about I love my sweet forever and a day.
That's not a record. You made it up.
Maybe it's not a record, but take it from me. That's well above average.
We want those jazz records, but our
go off like that? Why didn't you just bring that boy here?
Why?
Yes, why?
Because of the way you scared Joe Scales. He thought the rest of the boys afraid to come here. Even that friend of mine.
Oh, the one with the noise contraption? Was he in the house at all hours?
He's trying to work up his nerve to come in.
Why? What's he afraid of?
You!
Me? Why should anyone be afraid of me? Tell me we'll have to work at his nerve much longer, and I'm going to manage the conference in London.
She already told me. He's joking. Maybe he'll come in. No, he's moving on.
Joe Scales' car is much louder.
I hear motorcycle Matt.
He's still working on his nerve.
Is Anna back again?
No. For all I know, she looked.
She went to a movie. Miss Gilbert, I do not need any help in the kitchen.
With all these examinations, things are upset.
Well, up to it.
Martyr and Dirty's remembrance.
But I'm not supposed to wash dishes. I break cleats.
What about Dan, Jackie, and Lily, too?
They're still finishing up the exam.
Do you know the population? Nguyen according to the lost census. Well, of course you do. So does Jack here, so does Dan and Fred and Lily.
You're being ridiculous.
What's 16 times 16?
Whoa.
Really? 256. Well done. What's 17 times 17?
289.
Very well done. Boss, we better keep this one.
Are there any questions you'd like to ask,
Mr. To help you interpret.
Have all I need on these proper examinations.
That's settled. Get along with things. Step along now.
Frank, can you please tell me to start giving them along?
Sure.
Peanut butter.
hope he doesn't get your dad upset.
He won't. He better not.
I heard about your father.
Lots of people hear about my dad and his work.
Well, it wasn't exactly about his work.
The way he eliminates waste motions and things like that.
What did you hear?
To tell you the truth, I was almost afraid to come here.
No!
And he didn't know whether to ask you out for the skate or not.
You haven't been listening to that little cheerleader, that Joe Scales.
How do you know?
Really? The things that boy would say about my father, why, he would say anything.
What?
You think my father is some kind of monster, when actually, he's friendly and agreeable and witty and has one of the sweetest tempers and...
So she's back, is she?
And the story's just absurd.
I see. What took her so long?
He must be calling to someone. Someone at the back of the house. When Dad calls to the back of the house, you can also hear him at the front of the house.
I can tell.
No reason why you shouldn't come here.
You mean that boy is down there right now?
I guess you better be getting along.
I guess I better.
Let's see that.
Wait, about the guest, I don't suppose, I mean, what I'm
yes.
trying to say is, will you be coming back?
I have seen you the day of tonight. Be seeing you.
Be seeing you.
Here's that fool.
Hi, Anne. Where are you?
Mother,
and the word associates a guest, there's nothing to it. She just shoots five words at you.
Swell, I'm in an awful rush.
You know, if we told Anne five words,
she could really pour it out on her when she asked.
If every time she popped a word at her, she could pop back a lot of answers, a whole string of associated words.
Of course, it wouldn't be right if we told Anne the words in the test.
No, it wouldn't, and I better get a move on.
Would it be right if we told her the first word is
I don't?
Or that the second word is black?
Please.
Foot hair bird.
You shouldn't have told me.
No, Martha, you certainly shouldn't have told her that the five words are knife, black, foot, hair, bird. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
I'm sorry. And try and get those words out of your mind. Try to forget that the five words are knife, black, foot, hair, and bird.
Forget them! After we've been drumming them in? Good night, I'm already thinking of the answers. Why do you do a thing like that?
Aren't you ever going to get down to business?
Right now.
That's what Mother told you to see the real one.
You are seeing them. Sorry, Mom.
Motorcycle passes by.
I think motorcycles are wonderful. You can make a lot of noise with a motorcycle.
Noise?
Anne is just reading through the text.
About time she did some breathing.
I think she has a crush on one of the boys at school.
Boss, here are the charts I worked out. Rotation of duties about the household. It's all functioning before I leave.
I wish you wouldn't, though. Dr. Burton said...
Dr. Burton? We better find a way to knock some sense into our eldest daughters.
They're perfectly normal. At least they want to be.
They want to be wasting a lot of time. And time is too precious.
Isn't it really so important to go to the mentoring conference?
A conference like this gives me an opportunity to speak about motion study to the entire world. The world can use a little more efficiency. And it's awfully good for business. Costs a lot for our family.
Remember when we first talked about the family we have? Our wedding day? You told me we'd have a wonderful life and a wonderful family. A great big family.
I warned you. Children from basements to the attic. From the floorboards to the chandeliers.
And when we went for a Sunday walk, you looked like Mr. and Mrs. Piper.
Mrs. Piper, shake hands with Mr. Piper. Mr. Piper, meet Mrs. Piper.
And when I asked you, just as an estimate, how many children, you told me, just as an estimate, many.
I remember the day on that train you tried to appear so blasé since we've been married 3 years.
And when I took off my hat, you gave me that loud whisper. Good Lord, woman, why did you tell me your hair was that color? Everyone here, to leer and wink.
I admit I shouldn't have done it. I was just so proud of you. And I wanted everyone to know that you were my wife. The rotations of duties are working out fine. The family's getting so that it runs itself.
You've thought of most everything, Mr. Piper.
Thank you, Mrs. Piper.
I don't think she's taking this examination seriously. She's just marking down answers as quick as she can go. She said something about being in her room.
What to do with that boy?
Perhaps she has more important things.
You aren't supposed to leave the table until you finish the examination.
I am finished.
That's impossible.
It's finished.
You marked all the questions the best you could.
Honestly, Dad, it was a snap.
A snap. We'll see how much of a snap it was.
You bet we'll see.
My goodness.
Anything wrong?
There doesn't seem to be anything the matter.
Ski market.
I will.
Yet?
Not yet.
Just keep working.
I will.
Jingo. You'd better tell the whole family about this.
You're right back. And we might as well open the kitchen.
appear to.
I don't know why. It makes me think back to the afternoon Dad left for Europe.
The last time we were all together. Do you remember what Mother said? She was right.
Right now is the happiest time in the world.
She said it like she meant us to remember.
It never occurred to us Dad had any intention of dying until
he was good and ready.
I think it occurred to Annie. I think maybe something happened that afternoon. Something that made her suspect.
The way I remember, Anne spent the afternoon taking a review exam for the school board.
Then
she was so late coming home.
Dad worried he might not even get to see her.
Because she was ready for the exam. To grade her paper, at least. She wanted something to tell Dad before he left.
The misunderstanding with Dad, Anne really took it to heart.
She felt awful.
I think he felt even worse.
You could tell. When he put on the show for him that afternoon to give
him a big send-off, he laughed and acted as though he thought everything was wonderful, but you could tell.
He kept watching for Anne.
It was his favorite show, too. Our invitation with him and Mother.
I still know it in my heart.
You always took the role of Dad.
I was Mother.
Remember? Ladies and gentlemen, our first guest this afternoon, Dr. Lillian Muller Gilbert.
Why, Sean, I'm so glad you could be here. Grace, I like your new hat. Why, Jenny, you bobbed your hair. Now, I'm not going to make a speech, but I'll be glad to answer any questions.
Miss Gilbert, did you really want such a large family, and if so, why?
Any other questions?
Who really wears the pants in your household?
Any other questions?
Thank you, Miss Gilbert, for your enlightening answers.
Our next speaker is Frank Bunker Gilbert. Now, please keep your seats. Don't be frightened. He's promised to limit himself to 2 hours and not mention the one best way to do work more than twice in the same sentence.
For the purpose of convenience, I've divided my talk into 30 main headings and 117 subheadings. I commence with the first main heading.
Mr. Gilbert, the superintendent at the factory needs your help at once.
We'll all be right over.
I'm much too tired.
her few examination?
I don't know.
Well, since you've got all the foolishness out of your mind, you do your very best.
Dad, I did my very best, but I haven't exactly gotten foolishness out of my mind.
And?
Oh, Dad, she's been studying herself sick.
I can't help it.
I can't understand why you haven't more sense.
Dad.
I'm glad I'm not the oldest. By the time he gets to us, things will be taken for granted.
I just don't see why Dad cares so much. Sometimes it seems like he's the strictest father in town.
Were there any calls for me? Or anything?
Larry,
did he say anything?
Did you say anything? A little. I helped your case.
How?
I didn't let him think you'd just be studying all the time for some exam. That's so dry. I gave him something colorful to think about.
What?
About all your other dates.
No!
I'm not so dumb. Anytime motorcycle Matt calls, just keep your brilliance to yourself.
What's the matter?
Now don't be push, Bart. It's not my fault if neither of you understand men.
Don't understand men. Watch how I handle Matt. He'd better.
What do you mean?
You know where he swings in with the motorcycle? This is the last time he swings. You gave me the idea.
What idea?
Nails and broken glass.
I was joking!
We better warn him.
I think he missed.
Robin.
My gosh.
It's Larry.
What's Larry doing on Matt's motorcycle?
Oh, no.
Things wrong with them. Things like...
to pick between the two.
I'll send them all later, Dad. I'll tell them what it means.
Don't you like ice cream anymore, Jackie?
Me!
Now, boss, let's go upstairs and say goodbye to the others.
Which ones are you going to bring back to them, Miss Piper? Slide rule.
What a wonderful idea, Mrs. Piper. Was it a good paper?
Yes.
Did you pass?
Yes.
the way you thought them.
Goodbye, everyone.
You learned how to multiply 2-digit numbers in your head.
Never mind, Darby.
Goodbye, everyone. Be seeing you.
Be seeing you. It's getting late. I've had friends put the bags in the car already.
Thank you. My Jingo. Mr. Chairman.
couldn't use them for the next two shows. In the meantime, thank you again so much for coming. Hope to see you again soon. Have a good night.